Hey guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Alexis, and today I'm going to be doing some DIYs for my son's first birthday. I am doing a Cocomelon themed birthday, but I definitely wanted to emphasize that it's his first birthday. I love the decor I've seen where they either spell out one with letters or they just have number ones. I think it's super cute just to emphasize, but still, you know, having Cocomelon. So I'm combining the two.
I went to Hobby Lobby and I found these like cardboard craft type letters. They're actually classified as paper mache letters. They have different sizes, and I was in love when I found these ones. They're huge, they're 16 inches tall, they're 3D, they're just super cool. They are $7.99 a piece, which is spendy, but the week that I did get these, they were half off. I will be painting these with Krylon spray paint in the color white and a high gloss finish.
Okay, so our ones turned out so cute. Let me show them to you. They look awesome. I'm really glad I did that gloss finish because it makes them look more high-end. You can't tell that they're actually just cardboard. I feel like it kind of hides that, so I'm very pleased. Okay, so those ones are for our centerpieces, and to complete it, we are going to be using these clear boxes. I have these from a baby shower, so I'm just repurposing them. You can get them off Amazon. You can get like four for $19.99, I believe, around there, 20 bucks. I want it to look more like an ABC block. I'm gonna print out some other letters to put on the other sides, and I don't want to have this lid, so I'm just gonna fold it in all the way. Then I'm taking a cylinder vase from the dollar store, and I'm just placing it in the middle. To fill the sides of my box, I'm going to be using mini balloons, putting them all around, and then filling this with sand. Because our number one is going to be coming out of the middle here. But let's get our balloons blown up. Got these balloons off Amazon. There's 200 of these for, I believe it was like $12 or $15. I'm going to have to double check. And they're mini balloons. Tape, just folding it over, because once I put in the balloon, they like pop up, so they're not staying in place. So I'm taping underneath them. So I've got it done. It's all filled with the balloons. I'm loving how it looks, but we're not done yet. So let's go on to the next step. I also got this pack of tissue paper. It's in all different colors from the dollar store as well. And 35 sheets come in this. All right, back to the number ones. So I got some printouts of Cocomelon double-sided. I'm gonna cut him out and I'm putting him on the number ones. Here we go. Let's see if it turns out like I've imagined. I'm wanting to put Cocomelon like so. Here it is. Look, guys, it's so cute. Turned out perfect. Double-sided. I love it. So to finish off these centerpieces, I'm using these long wooden dowels. They were 69 cents. At Hobby Lobby, and they are 36 inches tall. I had to get these very large because These ones are hollow inside, so this dowel has to go all the way through to the top and then have the space to come out. So I'm gonna go ahead and make a hole and we'll see what happens. Just to let you guys know, these are not hollow all the way through. There's like something inside, like a stiff paper almost. So I have a lot of excess left. So you could use shorter dowels for sure. Oh my goodness. This is so cute.
Guys, I'm so excited. This is how it turned out. Aren't they adorable?
They're literally adorable. I am so pleased with myself right now. Oh my goodness, you guys. I love these centerpieces. They're so, so cute. They are just how I imagined in my head. And please excuse my mess everywhere because our birthday's tomorrow and I have stuff flung all over the place. But let me show you how these turned out.
Just want you guys to remember that these centerpieces can be customized to, you know, whatever theme you guys are doing. It could be anything, any character, any colors, change out the balloons to whatever you guys are doing and totally customize it to your own.
Poster board that I got at the dollar store. Nice and thick, sturdy. This is gonna be my welcome sign.
I have another cutout of JJ. It's just single-sided this time because I'm gonna cut him out and paste him down.
I found these borders so cute. We're doing a lot of rainbow colors and Cocomelon throughout the party just because Cocomelon's like rainbow and bright colors and all of that. These worked out perfect. These borders were also from the dollar store. Oh, they're shimmery. This is gonna go around the edges of the border. I found these super cute letters. And I'm going to be creating the wording on the sign with these. Then we've got some other decals just to add a little bit more decor on there.
Okay, I've got all my border on. Now let's put on the letters. Again, this welcome sign can be fully customizable to whatever it is you guys are doing with your party. I'm just so excited to show this to you because it's such a cheaper option than ordering one that you have to get printed and everything when you can just make one yourself. This cost me about $5. Here it is. I really love this.
Something else that I found at Dollar Tree that was so adorable and I didn't think of it until I saw it was this little sign. It's a year of firsts and I thought it'd be so cute just to put little bullet points of some of the things, you know, his first tooth, his first step, all those types of things. It'd be super cute and I'm gonna put it up on display for the guests to look at. Okay, I got my year of firsts fill out. And it's so cute. So I've got his teeth, his first time he had food, the first time that he took a step, our first trip, first time he went swimming. So his first word, so cute. I'm really glad I found this. Such a good deal for $1. All right, I got, these frames, they were marked down 99 cents for a 5-count pack. Now, what I want to do with these is I wanted to create a banner of his first year. So newborn through 1 year old, so through 12 months. So I will be using 13 of these. I don't like the gold, so I'm just going to spray paint these in white. I will be using Krylon white in satin finish.
So I just picked up some pictures from Walgreens. I slipped them behind these frames. I'm just putting scotch tape on that, and then I'm putting painter's tape behind to put those up on the wall, the months, and I just whipped those up on Microsoft Word. I then found this blank banner, which was totally unexpected. I was not going to do anything like this, but when I found it, I couldn't resist but to make another customized sign. I'm going back in with these letter stickers, and here's how it turned out.
Guys, it's been a busy day. I've literally been going all day. Those centerpieces were very time consuming, especially because I had to make all those letters and cut them out and paste them on. So I love how they turned out. They're extremely beautiful, but time is precious right now. The birthday is tomorrow. So I got all those six big centerpieces done, and then I have six small side tables as well. So I'm gonna do a smaller centerpiece. First thing is the number ones. I tried to get the same kind, the craft cardboard ones that I did for the large centerpieces of the number ones, but they were all sold out. What I opted to do was I just got a piece of computer paper and cut out a one. I'm going to be using my foam sheet end. I'm gonna trace them on here, cut them out, put them on a stick. Okay, so I have my number ones cut out of my foam, and I have some wooden dowels that I got at Hobby Lobby. There's a 30 pack for $2.99. And then I have the same Cocomelon printouts. They're just smaller.
Literally, I don't know why I keep saying Cocomelon when his name is JJ.
For the base of these centerpieces, I got these yellow planters. Let's see, they're about 6 inches wide at the top.
Also from the dollar store.
We are using these square floral foams, which are also from the dollar store. So first off, we'll get these inside. I'm gonna have to trim the edges just a tad. We got our foam in our planters here. And I'm taking that same packet of tissue paper, put it in the middle. Poke a hole through our centerpiece. And stick them in. There he is. Super simple, but cute.
I really wanted table runners that were rainbow, so a way I was able to do that, which was very budget friendly, was I found these tablecloths on Amazon. And since the rainbow is red, orange, yellow, green, blue, purple, I decided that I could make two table runners out of one tablecloth if I cut between the red ending and the purple beginning. I'm using this poster sheet that I got from Hobby Lobby. They're only 29 cents. I'm going to fold it in half, and then I'm going to trace some clouds. Okay, I've got my two separate clouds here, and I'm going to be using these on the end of one table runner, which is gonna go on my dessert table. Here's how it's looking. I'm gonna go ahead and tape this in place. Here's how the table runner turned out. It's gonna look so cute.
Thank you so much to everyone who watched this video. If you enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up. I really hope that it just gave you guys some ideas to go out and try. I will go ahead and I will link those Amazon items that I have mentioned in the description box below. Stay tuned to watch how my son's birthday did turn out when everything came together. I will see you guys next time.